that, you'd be 26 times better off in terms of global warming, 28 times better off.
Yeah.
In fact, it would be a huge, huge benefit for energy and for...
We fixed water quality issues by doing this, but then we've created a greenhouse gas. They put it together up in Massey University, so it takes into account soils, cow numbers, water use, concrete catchment, rainfall, low rate irrigation in 90 days for high rate, and that was based on 50 litres of water per cow per day, plus rainfall.
So it's converting it to electricity is a bit more functional.
But presumably, you mean that there are options in terms of burning the gas in terms of heating.
Yep,
definitely. Right?
So yep, but we need hot water, so that's certainly an option.
Can't promise anything at the moment, but we're hoping by the end of...
And is there anything in terms of the kind of design of the Ekron ponds compared to a conventional kind of treatment system? Is there anything you're doing differently in terms of the design of it?
Separate the solids out before storing the liquid effluent.
Yeah.
So we'd put in a mechanical solid separator or passive settling sludge bed with a weeping wall. And that means...
So the one you're bridging, it's much easier to bridge. And you also have, once you put a lid on, you've got to be able to get rid of the nutrient.
The sludge.
So you can't just take the lid off.
Neighbours were complaining about farms in the area that they could smell the odour coming off their pond, so we were looking into ways of eliminating that. So then we, if everything sort of interlocked and we're all on a different pathway, and now we're heading for the one